So Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals offense really had their way with the Jaguars defense. I know it's Jacksonville. They don't have the best defense, but I really do think that Joe Burrow, he was fantastic. And let's just get into what he did well. A lot of it was plays like this. A lot of it was when Jacksonville, you know, quick early on, Jacksonville tried to play some man. It wasn't working. They switched the zone, but that didn't work either. Cincinnati was able to have a lot of zone busters and a lot of routes over in the middle, and they were able to find a lot of success with that. Like, the way this play works is, you know, it's zone coverage. You have a player two Burrows left, just run a deep route. Then you can have a player two Burrows right, run a route that's going to kind of get underneath. And the point of this is that the deep route is going to get a defensive player, you know, a safety further deep. It stretches the gap in coverage over the middle where Burrow can make this throw. As you see, Burrow's able to make it. It's not an incredibly high degree of difficulty throw, but he did a good job, timed well. He threw it in between. Actually, threw it a little bit earlier, but he threw it in between two linebackers, which is what you want to do. That makes that gap even bigger. And that's just a lot of what he was able to do. It's just plays like that. But I thought there was some nuances with these zone busters that he was able to really take advantage of. And it wasn't just like he was making easy throws. For example, this one, it's going to be a cover three zone. And it's kind of a similar idea. You know, again, player runs over the middle. That's where Burrow's going to want to hit. This time, the player two Burrows left is actually going to cut short. But it's a similar idea. But what I like about this is that, for one thing, there actually is going to be some pressure that's going to get to Burrow. But also, what I like about it is look at how much air is going to be underneath this throw. Burrow does sort of loft it up there a little bit, partially because he kind of had to, because the pressure was coming. He had to get the ball out before too long, so he did throw it up there, and he kind of just, you know, got to his spot, but he put a little bit more air under it, so that way he gave his tight end time to get there. You know, you have to throw it to the open spot. You can't necessarily just throw it to your receiver, or in this case, a tight end. So what Burrow did was he just put air under it, so that way he could get to the spot while still giving his teammate an opportunity to make the play. This admittedly isn't the craziest play you will ever see from a quarterback, but considering the fact that it's a rookie quarterback who's already doing some of these little things well, that's what I look for in a quarterback, is those little things, being able to just see a small thing and being able to take advantage. And that's exactly what Burrow's able to do. And it's really impressive, I think, that a rookie quarterback is doing so many little things so well. Like, watch, this next one's another one where it's going to be zone coverage. Once again, it's his cover two zone. In Cincinnati, they have a player who's on that side of the field who's going to run deep. You have your halfback run underneath. Kind of the idea is that, you know, they're both going to be near one zone. And since this is zone coverage, basically that one player can only cover one of the two guys. So therefore, Burrow can simply just throw it to the other guy. And hopefully they'll get open and pick up this first down on second down and six. That's the idea right here. But what you're going to see is that, you know, it's play action. Burrow fakes the handoff, and then he looks over, and this play isn't working out too well. Also, one quick correction. I had the wrong thing on the board. I said it was a halfback. It's actually a tight end who sort of flashed over there. So I put the wrong graphic up, but nevertheless, it's the same idea. But, you know, anyways, Jacksonville did a great job of, you know, someone realized what was going on. He's taking away the route that Burrow wanted to throw to. If you look at Burrow, he is looking in that direction, but it's not open. So what is Burrow going to do instead? Well, Burrow's simply just going to say, hey, you know what? I have a great halfback I can throw a check down to. I'm just going to get off my first read, get to my second read, throw the check down, and then Joe Mixon, he's able to do the rest. And listen, Joe Mixon's quite, definitely a great guy to be able to throw a check down to. That guy is obviously a monster, and he's a monster in open space. He's a monster when there's not open space. He's able to do a great job of getting the first down right there. But again, that's just a good play. You know, the cliche expression, you can't go broke making a profit. Well, you know what? I mean, this is what you want to do. You want your young quarterbacks to sort of learn, hey, sometimes it's okay to not take a risk. Sometimes it's okay to do something that's, you know, just get a small play. You don't like to see quarterbacks when they're young always just do the safe play, but Burrow doesn't really. He will take a risk, but he also sometimes realizes when he shouldn't, which is, again, it's incredible that he's doing it at such a young age. Honestly, I know he's a little bit older than most rookie quarterbacks, so maybe that factors in, but just the patience he has. You'll see it on this play where it's zone coverage, and he looks so calm on this play. So a player is running over the middle. You know, this could get into a gap in coverage. It's before the safeties, but also, you know, in between linebackers, there will be a gap where he can get open. However, after this ball is snapped, this gap is a lot wider than Cincinnati even expected going in. Linebackers Joe Schobert and Miles Jack, who, on a side note, those are probably, you know, that's probably the best position grouping of this Jacksonville Jaguars defense. But, you know, they're two good players. But, you know, Schobert, who's on the bottom, he's the one who is in the circle with the Cincinnati player. He moves further down to sort of try to push him out of the way. But the problem is, since that Bengals player is running over the middle, he's going to get open. And Burrow knows that this is almost guaranteed to be a completion and a first down. But what I like about this from Burrow is I feel like a lot of young quarterbacks are just getting ready to make this throw now. You know, they're already deciding to make this throw now. They're going to make it as soon as he gets open, as opposed to waiting a little bit to allow him to get as open as possible. But not Burrow. Watch his patience. Watch how he waits a little bit, then makes that throw and is able to pick up that completion. It just, he's so calm in the pocket. You know, this reminds me of Jared Goff a little bit, where, you know, Goff is really good at that too. Where just sort of be patient, wait for someone to get open, and then once someone is open, then make the play. Obviously, there are times as well where you can't be patient. You have to get rid of the ball quickly. But again, Burrow knows what to do. He just looks so calm in the pocket. And, you know, we see guys who are in like their fifth and sixth years who look erratic. I mean, Ryan Fitzpatrick is like 37 and he looks erratic, whereas Burrow is incredibly calm. And it's insane to watch at such a young age. Like, watch, this one's another one. Again, zone coverage. Player runs over the middle. That's the way this works. So, you know, again, very, very simple to what they've been doing all day. It's another one of these types of concepts. Jacksonville's really struggled to stop them. But what you're going to notice this time is that a defensive back does a pretty good job of slowing down that receiver. So Burrow, you know, he's already been waiting now for a decent amount of time. He wants to get rid of the ball now, basically, but he can't because, you know, this play is just taking a little bit longer to develop than he had hoped. But the advantage is, you look at the pocket, he has time to throw. And this isn't something that Burrow has had a lot so far this season. I actually feel like this is something that maybe this could be a glimpse in today's or yesterday's day. Could be a glimpse into the future a little bit of if Cincinnati can build an offensive line, this could be a very fun team to watch because Burrow with time is incredible. He realizes he has time. And so again, he's patient. He's going to let the play develop. He wouldn't do this if he was under pressure, but he sees that he's not. So he waits and then makes the throw, which allows them to get the first down. He didn't panic, which is a lot easier said than done, quite frankly. I really like Joe Burrow, and I really like what he's doing with Cincinnati. I think he's playing some really good football. And, you know, listen, it's again, with rookie quarterbacks, I'm less concerned about the stats, quite frankly, but his stats are obviously very good, and his tape is very good. He's doing a lot of things that a lot of young guys don't do. He's already playing at a high level. I think maybe the only thing I would really be concerned about with Burrow is I don't know how much better he's going to get. He still has his rookie mistakes. I didn't really get into that too much in this video. There are some bad throws here and there. But for the most part, and you know, he does take a couple chances, and the chances have worked out so far. So maybe some in the future, some of these risks won't work out. But as a whole, I mean, I think he's playing really good football. And my only concern about him really is I don't know how much better he can get. He can definitely get better. I don't know how much better he can get. But listen, I mean, that's not really that much of a concern to have, I think. I think Cincinnati fans are pretty okay with the fact that my biggest concern about their quarterback is he's already very polished. I think you got to feel pretty good about that. So that's what I think of Joe Burrow. Very fun to watch. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, as always, thanks for watching.